Hi guys, today we'll see methods in Java. So here we'll study what if method, what if the definition. That is the, what is the syntax of writing the methods. Okay. First, what if methods in Java. Method in Java is a collection of instructions that is perform a specific task. Means the method is a block of code or collection of statements or a set of code which are being grouped together to perform certain specific task. So method is a collection of instructions which is used to perform the set of task. So what are the main importance of methods? Why we are using the methods only? The first one, that is advantages of using the methods. First one, code reusability. Means what? We write the code once and use it many times. So we can write the code once, we can use that code repeatedly, frequently. Okay, repeatedly we can use it wherever it is required. No need to write the code repeatedly. Means whatever the set of code that we have written, we can give the proper name and save it. And wherever is required, just we can call that method so that we did not have to write the same code repeatedly. First, modularity. It helps us to manage the complex and bigger programs into the smaller, manageable and understandable subparts. So here, second one is modularity. Means what? The complex, bigger program can be broken into the smaller and the manageable and understandable subparts by using the method. Third point is abstraction. It will hide the implementation details from component using the method. So how actually we are going to use all these importance? So where we are going to use? So we'll study it in subsequent videos. Okay, so that you will understand what do you mean by code reusability, what do you mean by modularity, what do you mean by abstraction. In detail you are going to study in subsequent videos. So next one is, what is method definition? In Java, method must be defined before it is used anywhere in the program. So general syntax of using the method in Java. First one, access specifier, return type, method name, parameter list and method body. So it should be within the curly braces. So what do you mean by access specifier? Access specifier will specify the access type of the method. It specifies the visibility of the method. Java provides actually four types of access specifiers. First one, public, private, protected and default. What do you mean by public access specifier? Means the method is accessible. When method is declared as a public, it means that method is accessible all the classes when we use public specifier. When we declare the method as a private specifier, that method will be accessible within the class where it is been defined. We cannot access that particular method outside the class. Protected. The method which is declared as the protected, it can be accessible within the same package or subclasses in the different package. Default means when we do not use any access specifier, like if you are not using any public, private, protected specifier, then the method is declared as default. Okay, when the method is declared declared as the default, it means it is visible only from the same package. This is about the access specifier, which is there in the first part of the method definition. Okay, next one is return type. Return type is the data type that method returns. It may have the primitive data type or object, collection, void, If method does not return anything, we use the void keyword. So next one is method name. Method name is the name of the method. It should be the valid Java identifier. Next one is parameter list. Parameter list is the list of the parameters which are being separated by comma, enclosed in the pair of parentheses. So it contains the data type and variable name. If the method has no parameter, means parentheses will be left blank. Next one is method body. So it is a part of the method declaration. It contains all the actions to be performed and it enclosed within the pair of curly braces. So we have theoretical we have seen. So what is method? Okay, what are the syntax of writing the methods? So how actually we have to write, where we have to write, how we are going to use this method, how we are going to call this method, we will see it in our subsequent videos. Thank you. Kindly subscribe and like our channel for further more videos. Thank you.